The theatre of the absurd has been playing out in full public glare on national TV, the Indian Problem League and its dirty underbelly exposed. The stage for this debate set by Siddharth Mallya's tweet now, he's gone out and questioned the integrity of the victim. He says that she asked for by BBM pin. This is not what a future wife should be like. He's used all sorts of expletives. The girl who's accusing Luke is saying that he hit her fiance. That's a load of asterisk, asterisk, asterisk. She was all over me last night. She asked for my BBM pin. This is not the way a woman who's going to get married should be behaving. Has he crossed the line? Or is Siddharth Mallya really stating some facts that this could be a woman who's seeking her 15 minutes of fame? I've got what I promise you will be a cracking debate lined up for you this evening. Joining us first and foremost from Mumbai, Shobha Day. Thank you very much, ma'am. Pleasure to have you on the show. Glad you could make it. With me in the studio is Dr. Subramanian Swamy, President of the Janata Party, here because he's demanded that the IPL be banned. He says that this mess has gone on for too long. The best solution now is to ban the IPL. Dilip Charan, founder of Perfect Relations, is with us. We've also got Shailendra Singh, Joint Managing Director of Perfect Limited, joining us from Mumbai. I want to first go across to Dilip. Siddharth Mallya going out and saying, and really turning this debate on its head, because so far the whole story was that here you've got an Aussie player who's molested this American national and the case was being investigated. He's now saying that, wait, this girl's not right. She tried to act fresh with me. She in fact came on to me. She took my BBM pin. This is not the way a future wife behaves. Do you think Siddharth Mallya has gone too far?
I think Siddharth Mallya has probably blown a whistle on one aspect of what's happening. You know, the IPL clearly has attracted a certain kind of groupie, camp follower kind of person, and without having to go deep into the phenomenon of why it's happening, the fact is that if this is the behavior that he's talking about, and let's assume for the moment that what he's saying is right, there's bound to be more evidence as to what this lady in question is also behaving like. So I'm sure that more worms will crawl out of the woodwork to say what's the situation. I'm not condoning what happened to her, but I'm saying, are there elements of... See, what happens is that everyone is so politically correct that nobody wants to say, are there elements of mutually consenting behavioral signals going on here?
You're saying this could have been mutually consensual. I want to go across to Shobha Day, because in which case Siddharth Mallya too is being a bit hypocritical. In the morning when he tweeted, he said, I don't know anything about it. I have no idea about what happened. Now he suddenly turns around and says, yeah, of course I know this woman. She tried to hit on me. She even asked for my BBM pin. Who's being hypocritical?
I think what's happening right now, Rahul, that as you rightly said, theatre of the absurd, that's an understatement. Everything is kind of going out of control. It has to do with money, it has to do with sex, it's got to do with alcohol, it's got to do with raging testosterone levels, it's also got to do with groupies and the kind of young women that the IPL after parties and the matches themselves are attracting. There is a fatal attraction between our cricketers and a certain kind of lady. Now what Siddharth Mallya is saying, I guarantee you, is well thought through. It's not something that just a young, hot-headed, immature owner of a team is saying in isolation. And the amazing part is that there will probably be a lot of people who will agree with him. Especially young India, because they'll probably see him as a hero. Now the whole IPL has gotten reduced to villains who are not villains, who are actually seen as heroes, women who are vamp-like but actually victims. It's a bit too complicated. But at the end of the day, if he's saying what he's saying, and there may be some element of truth, and I'm sure he'll be able to establish that as to who asked for the BBM pin, etc., then I'm afraid the lady will have to do damage control of her own.
Well, the lady showed
at the end of it all, we do decode body language, signals and the rest.
Because there's been a lot of talk on Twitter and on social media, and I want to go across to Shailendra Singh and even ask him whether these points are fair, because people have been asking that when she spoke to you early in the morning, you know, she was wearing a different set of clothes, then she comes and she's wearing a completely different dress, her hair's all done up, she's got makeup. Now somebody who's been through such an experience wouldn't do this unless she was seeking her 15 minutes of fame. Are those valid questions to ask, or do you think that we should take the woman at face value and the matter should be investigated?
Well, Rahul, I think I was in on your panel today to discuss the Indian sort of problem leak. I think that was the larger issue, but I think we've managed ourselves a brilliant soap episode with this lady and the accusations of nearly, I mean, rape is a very serious offense. I'm not going to play to the gallery of Siddharth Malia, because this sounds like, you know, being back in college with brawls, but this is a serious one, serious issue. So I'm going to just digress from this and go back to the history, because I think Rahul is a very important point to be made. I know that media likes this. I know nobody's carrying the story of global meltdown or 20 kids dying in Calcutta. I know this plays to the gallery, but having said this, India as a country is not used to creating intellectual properties. You must understand that we import everything from soft drinks to cars. Indian IPL is a global intellectual property, first time created out of India. Now it's been landed with controversies from day one, Narendra Modi being sacked, IPL going to South Africa, match fixing, Shah Rukh Khan and whatnot. Now, let me just tell you, where is the issue? The issue is the leadership. Who is running IPL? Where is the CEO? Where is the imaging consultant? Where is the spokesperson for IPL? Why isn't somebody taking this bull by the horn? IPL is not a property of BCCI or MCA or Shah Rukh Khan. IPL is a property made by Indians. Indians have invested into it. IPL is a property that is actually filling a livelihood for many people in this country and entertainment. And all of us actually enjoy this. This is the property of India. Who has the right to go and destroy an intellectual property created by all of us? And these episodes, I mean, for God's sake, will somebody actually run the IPL and take accountability of it? I mean, Shah Rukh's episode should have never happened. It happened. Why did it happen? There were hundreds of officials there. They should have restricted the incident. And today, they're saying in the morning, saying another one, and now he's abusing your own journalists of your channel. I mean, is this all for real? So I'm seriously worried that once again, India will again lose a big intellectual property that is pretty much owned by all the citizens of this country.
Because there was a loud chorus, and the chorus seemed to be getting louder with every passing hour, that let's ban the IPL. This is too filthy, it's too murky, let's ban the IPL. At first I thought it was being said in jest. Subramanian Swamy joined in, Lalu Prasad joined in, Kirti Azad has been leading a charge, everybody's been saying that this is filthy, let's ban the IPL.
Yes.
Is that not taking things too far, Dr. Swamy?
Listen, there's something called a tipping point. This is not only the fact that somebody grabbed some woman in a hotel. That's not the issue. The IPL issue was building up because there was money laundering, there was corruption, there was black money, there was prostitution, there was all kinds of nefarious involvement of mafia characters from Dubai. I think this is a great threat to the national security. And I don't care whether it is we are importing this or not. The fact of the matter is, it's totally inconsistent with Indian culture, and therefore we need to ban it.
I think, you know, that it's great to look at the fault lines as far as a product like this is concerned. But the fact is that somebody ought to clean up all the stuff around the game. And I think what Sharinder said is right, that somebody ought to take charge and clean up the acoustics, as it were, and understand that this is not cricket, this is just a game, this is just a play where owners are creating franchises, and this is part of a whole entertainment system. But the sleazy parts of it definitely need to be sliced, and this is a great opportunity for someone to do that.
Well, I think, may I come in here, and I have said my statement which you referred to, that one of the ways of cleaning up is to ensure that no politician and no cinema person gets into this game at all. It is dealt with professionals who are concerned with.
Okay, I want to go across to Rohan Gavaskar. Is it becoming a choreographed sport where everybody knows it's a bit like the WWE? You are around, but everybody's watching it, they're having popcorn, grabbing a beer, but nobody believes it. You know, it's not for real.
Well, no, I don't think it's a choreographed sport because, you know, I don't give it to that. I'm not saying spot fixing doesn't happen. We've just seen five young cricketers giving to the temptation of spot fixing, agreeing to, you know, bowl a no ball when they play IPL. But to choreograph an entire game, it's very, very tough. It's to, you know, to fix a game is very tough. I don't think that happens. I may be naive over here. I played a season of IPL in the third edition of IPL. And not once did I get the feeling that there was something amiss. So look, I don't think it, when you watch a game, I'm just talking about the game, the 40 overs that are played out on the field, that can't be fixed. Everything else around it, well, who knows, may be fixed, may not be fixed, to get eyeballs, to get some, the TRPs up. But the actual game, the actual sport of, you know, bat versus ball for 40 overs, I don't think that's fixed.
China, would people start disbelieving what they see, think of it as a tamasha? They might still watch it, but they only think of it as a tamasha, they don't take it seriously.
There are a couple of points here. First, you have match fixing. Then you have money laundering. Then you have a rape case. Then you have people being aggressive. Then there are questions of whether people are drinking, smoking, etc. All in all, if we're focusing on cricket, surely you can have cricket and positive entertainment. You don't need to have cricket and sleaze and prostitution and all the negatives in society. I think that Kirti Azad's demand is absolutely justified, where he says there needs to be a high power committee that looks into matters of IPL. If you don't have the leadership to deliver in a sport such as cricket, you're going to have stories like this every single day. Today it's a girl accusing Siddharth Mallya. Who knows whether it's true or untrue, but the point of the matter is eventually he is an owner of a team, and this is a story. Whether it's a cricketer who's involved in match fixing, whether it's Shah Rukh Khan who is aggressive, why? Was he provoked? Was he not provoked? Are the MCA officials to be blamed? Are the BCCI officials to be blamed? All the questions have multiple answers, and unless you have the leadership and political will to establish who is guilty and who is not, we will only be debating and the game will go on.
Well, you know, you mentioned Shah Rukh Khan being banned. In the midst of all of this, we've seen Mamata Banerjee jump into the debate. Say, Shah Rukh is Bengal's brand ambassador. How can Mumbai go and ban him? So this has become an out-and-out Mumbai versus Bengal issue now, where Mamata Banerjee has jumped in. So I want to, you know, deal with the issue of Shah Rukh being banned just for a moment and ask Shobha Davis.
Why is he banned? Why is he banned? Why is he banned?
I mean, where is BCCI?
Mumbai Cricket Association says that he got physically abusive, our officials were there, and therefore they banned him for five years.
You have him.
Do you think China is a success?
But isn't it fair that a father would protect a 13-year-old child who's being manhandled? And if he's gone on record saying that those children were only playing on the side and they would have come out if you just told us to leave, what was the need to get aggressive or provoke somebody? Let's view it in totality rather than dissecting this issue and making him into this drunkard, habitual offender, which he wasn't.
But Shobha Day has a hand up. I want to listen to what she has to say. Do you think the 5-year ban is excessive, ma'am?
Forget whether the 5-year ban is valid or not, but I think this whole business of a 13-year-old child being manhandled came as an afterthought.
Yeah,
what we saw the clips and what everybody around the stadium, the people who were there, there was no question at that stage when he was out of control and abusive of him accusing them of manhandling either his own child or any other child. I think this was a much later strategy to try and justify whatever had happened. You know, this whole thing is being blown into a very ugly spat where the parochialism that's been brought into it,
Rahul,
and now with Mamata Banerjee getting into it, at the end of it all, it's only about money and nothing else. I heard yesterday, to my astonishment, that, you know, he's such a big national icon. There are billions of dollars riding on him, and how can we blame him for losing his cool? I heard that from a co-panelist. So if it's only about money and it's only about billions of dollars, then icons should behave like icons, for heaven's sake, and behave responsibly, whether it's him, Siddharth Mallya, or anybody else.
Shah Rukh was provoked that he's not at fault, but surely as a celebrity, he ought to have laid the right example, China.
No. Absolutely correct. Maybe he should have handled it in a different format, but the fact of the matter is the photographs were taken only after Shah Rukh Khan came onto the stadium. When the children were playing, nobody even said anything. The children went and complained to the father, saying that the security guards are pushing us out and manhandling us. The fact of the matter is any father, irrespective of being a celebrity or not, would have gone and responded. Should he have responded differently? Probably yes. But to say that, you know, this is a reason to ban Shah Rukh
Khan from entering Wankhede Stadium. Please, this is an argument that could have happened between any two people. There was no physical fight. There was no, contrary to what everyone's trying to project. He had not come there drunk. He had come from his residence after the 19th over.
No, I think that
Shailendra wants to come in as Shahrukh, become a pawn in a political game. Yeah. Shailendra, you know, you've got Vyasrav Deshmukh saying no, MCA will not allow Shahrukh in. You know, you've got Rajiv Shukla saying no, MCA can't take its decision. BCCI will tell MCA what to do.
Exactly.
You've got Mamata Banerjee jumping in and saying no, he's Bengal's ambassador, he can do no wrong. So it's all actually about politics
and theatre of the absurd.
Actually, Rahul, just to go back a bit in history, I think the issue with Bollywood coming very close
to justification
to
for bad behavior.
Yes, Shailen.
True. I agree with that, Shana. But Rahul, I just have a point that if you go back in history, that BCCI actually found cricket coming very close to Bollywood, and Shahrukh watched a match with Lalit Modi in Jaipur way before IPL. And BCCI actually had a mandate in writing that Bollywood will not be allowed to be present in any official BCCI box. This was a rule made. And 3 weeks later, Shah Rukh Khan owned the first cricket team of IPL. And since then, for 5 years, I think 90% of exposure that IPL gets is due to Bollywood celebrities. Having said that, MCA today has taken a lot of glory for this incident. Fair enough. Maybe this really happened. Shah Rukh crossed the line. But to ban Shah Rukh Khan, I mean, is it really the game plan of MCA and BCCI going forward? Is this going to work for IPL? I mean, that's what I'm saying. It's all about leadership. Somebody needs to take the bull by the horn. Somebody needs to stand up from BCCI and IPL.
Shailendra, are you saying that Rajiv Shukla is doing a pathetic job? That Lalit Modi brought this upon us? Direct questions. You're saying Rajiv Shukla doesn't know what he's doing, Shailendra. That Lalit Modi brought this upon us. While he was there, things were still better. And now that Lalit Modi is gone, so are you saying that Rajiv Shukla is not doing his job properly, Shailendra?
No, okay. Shailendra should tell us who do you think should be leading this.
Yeah. I'm going to go across to Shailendra just a moment. I want to bring Dr. Swamy because politicians seem to be at the root of it. You know, because the fact is, it's all a political war between Rajiv Shukla, between Vilasrao Deshmukh, Mamata Banerjee. Everybody is in it for themselves. Everybody else is a scapegoat at the hands of politicians.
Well, then therefore, you have a rule saying no politician should be involved in this. It's a game. It's a first-class game. I myself played it for my school and 1 year of my college. It's a superb game, and this has been given a new dimension with the Sehwags and Dhoni's have converted this from a lazy game into an active game, and 2020 is one of those inventions, like the 50-50 was. So I don't know whether it was Shobha or somebody else who said it, bring this back to cricket. What is this? What is this? You have women with the underpanties showing, cheering for 4 and 6. They don't even know that because they come from Uzbekistan. They don't know anything about cricket. Now, why do you have that? This is too titillate. And I'm afraid that this seems to be behind it. I know many politicians who visit hotel rooms after the match because the patronage is necessary of politicians. You don't ask me to reveal what I know about this game. This game stinks. It's against our national interest, and certainly it is also against our country.
Go on.
One of them is about Shahrukh's ban. And you know, the thing is, at the end of the day, BCCI has said, like, look, they need to come to us and we'll ratify it. If they don't ratify it, it's a win-win situation for all, because the Mumbai Cricket Association will not come out looking like lions. They'll come out looking like lions because they took the step of banning Shah Rukh Khan for 5 years, though the BCCI overruled it. So, you know, everyone's happy. In case the ban does stand, Rahul, for the life of me, I can't understand what is the big deal. Shah Rukh Khan, how many times has he gone to the Wankhede Stadium in this last 30-40 years? Maybe twice, thrice, when the Knight Riders have played. He wasn't even there a couple of days ago when his team was playing. So how is it going to affect his life in any way? It's going to make no difference to Shah Rukh Khan that he's banned him for 5 years or 50 years.
Okay, you know, we're hearing that the girl who allegedly got molested by Luke Thomas Bach is saying she will sue Siddharth Mallya for the comments that he's made. We're also hearing politicians say, shut down the IPL. So now, before I end this debate, I want to hear from all our guests on what the solutions are. You know, are there any solutions, Dr. Subramanian Swamy? Because shutting it down, is that the only solution you
can
think of?
I'm not saying shutting it down. You are overstretching it.
You said it.
Well, I certainly think that you should shut it down right away. And I said in my statement that you can remove the ban once the politicians and the cinema people are taken out of it. And this is run by professionals. And I think it's very unfair for you to attack Mr. Kirti Azhar.
I didn't attack him. I said attack.
You said it because he hates...
I didn't say it. And there's an angle over the internal party angle.
There is no internal party angle at all. Jetli can look after himself. And he's saying that politicians go out means a lot of politicians will go out. In fact, more Congress people will go out like Sarath Pawar and Rajiv Shukla than BJP people. So I think it's not fair to ascribe motives to a very good suggestion. I think politicians don't belong here, and they should be doing other things for their constituency.
I think there are two issues here. One is a business of national culture, which is actors behaving the way they should, women behaving the way they should, all of that. And there's a second, which is managing sports. Get politics out of sports, let sportsmen dominate it. That's the only thing, and let there be great business opportunities, because this country definitely needs more by way of sports and not less.
Shailendra Singh, is there a solution?
This is a big... Yes, Rahul, there is a very, very serious solution. This is a big business, this is a big sport. This is pride of India. The world watches cricket coming out of India, and we bring in 90% of global cricketing revenue. Having said that, this particular sport needs to be professionalized. You need proper governance and accountability, and you need to put this in public domain. This no more can be like a private Raj run. It is not working. I mean, let's just be factual about it. And I don't think the entire nation really wants to lose cricket or IPL. We all want it. We want it clean, and we want it with proper governance.
Mohan Gavaskar, can't be a private cabal.
Rahul, another small point, Rahul.
Yes.
Rahul, the rules are a bit inconsistent. If you saw Delhi Daredevils match last night, the same thing of Shahrukh's kids was happening with the owner's kids. He had a massive couch right on the boundary line, and his children were waving flags. They were on the ropes, and the camera was actually featuring the kids having a great time. Now, that's a very thin line. Just an incident 24 hours ago with Shahrukh's kids, and the owners of Delhi Daredevils kids were right on the ropes having a blast.
Yes. So, I mean, it's the IPL, there are no rules. Everything goes. Rohan Gavaskar, you know, is it doing more damage than good to Indian cricket, to the world of cricket? Is everybody getting
You know, when we talk about the five guys who were caught on camera admitting to spot fixing, they were saying one of them admitted to spot fixing in domestic cricket, not the IPL. So are you going to ban domestic cricket? I remember an incident in the late 90s where Ricky Ponting allegedly behaved very badly with a lady in a nightclub in Calcutta. That was an international match between India and Australia. For that, are you going to ban international cricket? These things happen outside the IPL as well. So look, you know, you can't do anything about it. The only thing, like Shailendra said, is you've got to have strict governance. If someone's found guilty of, being involved in the terrorist activities, you've got to give them the harshest punishment and make sure they, as individuals, never play in the IPL again. But you can't ban the IPL.
Nobody said that just because of this one incident, the thing should be banned. This, I said, is a tipping point. There are so many dimensions to it. If I said all that I knew, I don't think this will be. I can say it on this TV. So therefore, a sharp look is necessary.
But there is a lot of pressure on Shah Rukh Khan from the BCCI to say sorry, to make up with the MCS, that life can go on, that some sort of a rapprochement should be found. Lots of people also saying that Shah Rukh is having an emotional meltdown. He's suffering from a midlife crisis.
No, I'm Rahul, I'm not Shah Rukh's psychotherapist or psychiatrist. I don't know about his meltdown, but certainly I think had he shown a slightly more humble attitude and admitted to some extent that despite a great provocation, he regretted what he had said, it might have sorted out this issue much earlier. But as to the question about the IPL, I think there's been an upside and a downside to the whole format of the IPL. The upside is that it did throw up a lot of young talent and gave opportunities to a lot of young cricketers. That was a very, very good side about the IPL. The downside is the money and the corruption, and that's a cocktail that's extremely heady and very hard for most people to down and still stay sober. So if at all, then you need checks and balances in place. You can't ban something like that. It's too late. And as for Shah Rukh Khan, I think a visit to his nearest shrink may not be such a bad plan.
You're asking him to visit a ship?
One word on the Maharashtra police. They have taken an action. We really don't know the full facts of what really happened. I don't know whether Shah Rukh Khan was subject to a medical test, because we want to know what state he was in. I know, just because he's a great actor is not enough. There are many of the great actors.
He wasn't. He was not.
Okay, Shaina?
He wasn't.
Shaina, this pressure on Shah Rukh to say sorry, to make up with the MCS, that life can go on. You know, people
may
can
I
go back
that?
Get their beer, you know, watch the IPL, sit back and just diffuse this crisis. Should he say sorry? Will he say sorry?
Well, like Shobhade said, I'm not his spokesperson either. But my personal opinion is it shows grace, because when somebody is big and says something like this, it just makes him that much bigger. But having said that, I'd like to answer what Mr. Swamy said. The fact of the matter is he was not under the influence of alcohol. And if he was, the Mumbai police did not even bother to check him on a breathalyzer or any of that. This was not a spat under the influence of anger. This was a father who was just protecting his child, and which got slightly out of hand. Of course, it shouldn't have happened. As far as the IPL, no match fixing, no money laundering, no sleaze, no prostitution, just cricket with healthy entertainment, good governance and a professional team to run.
Shailena Singh, before I conclude, do you think Shah Rukh should say sorry, because the BCCI is trying to find a solution, and that solution they're saying is Shah Rukh says sorry, the MCI said okay, then we'll consider forgiving you?
No, the good news, Rahul,
I'm going to go back to Shailendra. Just a moment, I want to get Rohan to answer that question first.
Sorry, Rahul, I couldn't hear.
Should Shah Rukh say sorry? There's a lot of pressure on him to say sorry. Should he just say, okay, I'm sorry this happened, let life go on as normal? Can it go on as normal?
Well, look, like Shaina said, it would be a big gesture for him to say sorry. But sometimes you've got to think, you know, if you feel you're the aggrieved party, and if you feel you haven't done anything wrong, why should you apologize? That's the way I look at it. I mean, if I haven't done anything wrong, if I feel I'm the aggrieved party, should I be the bigger man and say sorry? Yes, I would. But sometimes when you're angry, your kids are, if you think your kids have been mishandled, manhandled, then look, I don't think I would say sorry.
Because Shailendra, he's feeling aggrieved at this time. He says, why should I say sorry? The MCA should say sorry to me. Do you think a solution can be found if he says sorry? Because the MCA has already banned him for 5 years, so they've done what they had to.
No, there's a court case. Let's see what happens in that court case.
Dr. Swamy likes to take everybody to court.
That's
the solution.
No, there is a court case. There's a police FIR registered, and it's a cognizable offense. And I think, it's a question of trial which has to take.
Yeah, I think Rahul, like I said to you before, there's going to be soon another breaking news, which is BCCI, MCA, Shah Rukh Khan will 100% hug and make up very soon. This is what my understanding of the sport and the pressure is. But having said that, I think an important issue, Rahul, to be made here is that Shah Rukh Khan, irrespective of what the circumstances were, I mean, I'm actually defending Shah Rukh in this case, but the way Shah Rukh has reacted and being the icon that is, the abusive language that he used, I think for that particular reason, Shah Rukh needs to do another press conference, that he does need to apologize to the nation, because he's heard in his voice using language that nobody ever expected out of Shah Rukh. So that maybe he needs to do, maybe play a bit of a humble card for his fans.
Kiss and make up? Shobha Day, do you think that will happen, or do you think he's too aggrieved, you know? There's too much passion, there's too much anger, he's not prepared to back down.
Rahul, I think Shah Rukh has read Eric's Agarwal, and love clearly means never having to say I'm sorry, because he said so in as many words. He went on the offensive instead of going on the defensive. He said they owe him an apology, and he thought nothing of using such just the worst language in the world in the front of children. The very children, he says, he was out there to protect, and he was very upset that they were being manhandled. But what about upsetting the whole country with use of abusive, very, very colorful and very strong abusive language? Is that acceptable? And do his children find that acceptable? That's the question he needs to ask himself.
He will apologize, because he's got a court case otherwise going.
Let's get a happy ending.
There must be a happy ending, and maybe an opportunity to bring everybody back on the discussion table once again. To all my guests for joining me on what's been a very, very surreal day. You know, the IPL turning out to be like the WWF. There's molestation, there's stuff fixing,
There are slaps, fisticuffs, it's all happening right here, and we'll keep getting you all the ringside action right here on Headlines today. For joining me, thank you very much. He's here because he's demanded that the IPL be banned. He says that this mess has gone on for too long. The best solution now is to ban the IPL. Dilip Charan, founder of Perfect Relations, is with us. We've also got Shailender Singh, joint managing director of Perfect Limited, joining us from Mumbai. I want to first go across to Dilip. Siddharth Mallya going out and saying, and really turning this debate on its head, because so far the whole story was that here you got an Aussie player who's molested this American national and the case was being investigated. He's now saying that, wait, this girl's not right. She tried to act fresh with me. She in fact came on to me. She took my BBM pin. This is not the way a future wife behaves. Do you think Siddharth Mallya has gone too far?
I think Siddharth Mallya has probably blown a whistle on one aspect of what's happening. You know, the IPL clearly has attracted a certain kind of groupie, camp follower kind of person, and without having to go deep into the phenomena of why it's happening, the fact is that if this is the behavior that he's talking about, and let's assume for the moment that what he's saying is right, there's bound to be more evidence as to what this
interaction between cricketers and a certain kind of lady. Now what Siddharth Mallya is saying, I guarantee you, is well thought through. It's not something that just a young, hot-headed, immature owner of a team is saying in isolation. And the amazing part is that there will probably be a lot of people who will agree with him, especially young India, because they'll probably see him as a hero. Now the whole IPL has gotten reduced to villains who are not villains, who are actually seen as heroes, women who are vamp-like but actually victims. It's a bit too complicated. But at the end of the day, if he's saying what he's saying, and there may be some element of truth, and I'm sure he'll be able to establish that as to who asked for the BBM pin, etc., then I'm afraid the lady will have to do damage control of her own.
Well, the lady showed that.
Because at the end of it all, we do decode body language, signals, and the rest.
Because there's been a lot of talk on Twitter and on social media, and I want to go across to Shailender Singh and even ask him whether these points are fair, because people have been asking that when the theatre of the absurd has been playing out in full public glare on national TV, the Indian Problem League and its dirty underbelly exposed. The stage for this debate set by Siddharth Mallya's tweet now, he's gone out and questioned the integrity of the victim. He says that she asked for by BBM pin. This is not what a future wife should be like. He's used all sorts of expletives. The girl who's accusing Luke is saying that he hit her fiancé. That's a load of asterisk, asterisk, asterisk. She was all over me last night. She asked for my BBM pin. This is not the way a woman who's going to get married should be behaving. Has he crossed the line? Or is Siddharth Mallya really stating some facts that this could be a woman who's seeking her 15 minutes of fame? I've got what I promise you will be a cracking debate lined up for you this evening. Joining us first and foremost from Mumbai, Shobha Day. Thank you very much, ma'am. Pleasure to have you on the show. Glad you could make it. With me in the studio is Dr. Subramanian Swamy, president of the Janata Party.
The lady in question is also behaving like. So I'm sure that more worms will crawl out of the woodwork to say what's the situation. I'm not condoning what happened to her, but I'm saying, are there elements of... See, what happens is that everyone is so politically correct that nobody wants to say, are there elements of mutually consenting behavioral signals going on here?
You're saying this could have been mutually consensual. I want to go across to Shobha Day, because in which case Siddharth Mallya too is being a bit hypocritical. In the morning when he tweeted, he said, I don't know anything about it. I have no idea about what happened. Now he suddenly turns around and says, yeah, of course I know this woman. She tried to hit on me. She even asked for my BBM pin. Who's being hypocritical?
I think what's happening right now, Rahul, that as you rightly said, theatre of the absurd, that's an understatement. Everything is kind of going out of control. It has to do with money, it has to do with sex, it's got to do with alcohol, it's got to do with raging testosterone levels, it's also got to do with groupies and the kind of young women that the IPL after parties and the matches themselves are attracting. There is a fatal attraction.
She spoke to you early in the morning. you know, she was wearing a different set of clothes, then she comes and she's wearing a completely different dress, her hair's all done up, she's got makeup. Now somebody who's been through such an experience wouldn't do this unless she was seeking her 15 minutes of fame. Are those valid questions to ask, or do you think that we should take the woman at face value and the matter should be investigated then?
Well, Rahul, I think I was on your panel today to discuss the Indian sort of problem leak. I think that was the larger issue, but I think we've managed ourselves a brilliant soap episode with this lady and the accusations of rape is a very serious offense. I'm not going to play to the gallery of Siddharth Maria, because this sounds like being back in college with brawls, but this is a serious one, serious issue. So I'm going to just digress from this and go back to the history, because I think Rahul has a very important point to be made. I know that media likes this. I know nobody's carrying the story of global meltdown or 20 kids dying in Calcutta. I know this plays to the gallery, but having said this, India as a country is not used to creating intellectual properties. You must understand that we import everything from soft drinks to cars. Indian IPL is a global intellectual property.